a lot of the press coverage, and when it comes to the Middle East, the press is wildly biased. A lot of the press coverage is focused on the differential of deaths between Israelis and Palestinians, and significantly more Palestinians died. There are numerous reasons for that. One of the reasons why the Israelis' deaths were more limited is because of Iron Dome, because many of those rockets that were fired were intercepted. Now, Hamas is deliberately targeting civilians in Israel. That's part of the definition of terrorism, is deliberately trying to cause civilian deaths, civilian injuries for a political purpose. Israel doesn't do that. Israel doesn't target citizens directly. So Israel does defend itself against those terrorists. Why did more Palestinians die? Well, one significant percentage of those Palestinians who died, died from Hamas rockets. They're not very good at this. They're fairly low tech. And so a significant percentage of the rockets that Hamas fires from Gaza landed in Gaza and killed Palestinians. So it's their own terrorists killing their own people because they wanted to kill Israeli civilians, but they just weren't very good at it and shot their own people instead. The press utterly ignores that. The other civilians that are injured are predominantly the result of a decision that Hamas made to use Palestinians as human shields. So they deliberately fire their weapons, fire their rockets from heavily populated civilian areas into heavily populated civilian areas. It's actually a double war crime. Shooting a civilian area is a war crime, but shooting from a civilian area is also a war crime. And what they're doing, so for example, the Hamas headquarters was in the basement of a hospital in Gaza. This is a Palestinian hospital. And here's the calculation Hamas is making. It's a win-win. Either the IDF will refrain from attacking their headquarters, in which case that's great, that's what they want. Or in the alternative, if the IDF does attack the headquarters, it will kill a significant number of Palestinians, and they're literally using Palestinian women's and newborn babies. There was a maternity ward in this hospital. Newborn babies as human shields because they can count on the useful idiots in the media blaming Israel for doing that. And I will tell you, having meeting with the Israeli military, they take extraordinary steps to minimize civilian casualties. They target with great precision the terrorists. They give warning. So if there's a building that they know there's a Hamas cell headquartered in, they'll drop a bomb that is a dud, that just makes a big loud clang on the roof, that is designed to tell the non-terrorist residents of the building, get out of the building. And they'll wait typically 30 minutes, 60 minutes before actually bombing the building. They'll call them on their phones. I don't know of another military on earth that calls the target of a bombing raid to tell them get out of the building. But the Israelis do that because the Palestinians are sticking innocent civilians. They put their rockets. Hamas puts their rockets. They put them in a kindergarten. They've used Palestinian kindergarten children to hide their rockets. You know, one of the things Prime Minister Netanyahu said that I thought was really powerful, he said, they use their citizens to protect their rockets. We use our rockets to protect our citizens, and there's not a moral equivalency between the two.
Thanks so much for watching this video. Be sure to hit the subscribe button so you never miss new content from the Daily Signal.